So if you've spent any time on this channel, you know that most of my videos focus on helping photographers get the most out of the Lightroom ecosystem. However, there are times when the amazingly talented people on the Photoshop team release a new tool that is just so mind-bogglingly cool that I have to show it. In case you're wondering what I'm talking about, a few days ago, the Photoshop team released an update to Photoshop Beta that includes two new features, Generative Upscale and Harmonize. And it's the latter tool that I'm just floored by. I know the Photoshop team has been working hard on Harmonize for a long time, and it's cool that they finally made it available for all Photoshop users to try out. Now, both Generative Upscale and Harmonize use AI to accomplish their respective tasks, and I know that AI may not be for everyone. But as I always say when it comes to these new tools, I highly recommend learning what it does and how it works so that you can equip yourself to make the best decision for your own workflows. All right, let's dive in. All right, so here we are on my desktop, and I always like to start with the very basic thing that you have to have Photoshop Beta installed. To do that, you'll click on the Creative Cloud desktop app on your computer, go to Apps, and then click on Beta. Now, it goes without saying that whichever Creative Cloud plan you are subscribed to has Photoshop included. If it does, you'll be able to download and install this. And so if it's not installed, kind of like Premiere Pro Beta is not installed, you'll have this install button. You can click on it and there you go. And also, if you are done with Photoshop Beta, you just don't want it on your computer anymore, just click on this little try dot over here and select uninstall, and that will remove it. So those are the basics of how to get Photoshop Beta on your computer. All right, so I've got Photoshop Beta installed. It's the latest version. And I'm gonna start with Generative Upscale. So you can see I have this photo. I took this in Coney Island many, 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 many years ago. Actually, it looks like it was 2011 with my iPhone 4. And you can see that this is a 1,000 pixel wide by 747 pixel high JPEG image. Now, I've had this photo in Lightroom forever, and we've had super resolution in Lightroom for a while, which basically doubles the width and the height of the pixels. But this is better. And what I mean by that is I can upscale by up to 4x. And the way to do that, you can either go to Image and then select Image Size, and then you'll have this handy dandy link right here, open in Generative Upscale. Or if you just want to go direct, you can go to Image and then select Generative Upscale right here. And it's pretty straightforward. If you select this dropdown, you have three options. You can double, triple, or quadruple the dimensions. And so, I mean, if I'm upscaling, I'm usually going to the max. In this case here, it's 4x. Again, super resolution was 2x. So I'm gonna go ahead and click on upscale. And you can see that it opened this image up in a new document right over here. And if I go back to image and select image size, and I'll change these units to pixels, you'll see that we are actually quadrupled. There is now 4,000 pixels wide by just about 3,000 pixels high. So I'm gonna cancel out here, and you can see we have this layer here which has some improvements made to it. And if I hide that, this is the upscaled image without the enhancements. And then this is the upscaled image with the AI enhancements. And so it just looks a lot better. All right, so now I want to move on to the feature that I'm very, very impressed with. It's called Harmonize. And this is basically, I would say, kind of like the answer to the photographers who like to or need to composite images. What I mean by that is you take one image and you want to combine it with another image seamlessly so that it kind of looks natural. Obviously, graphic designers and photographers do this all the time. We've been doing this forever using layer masks in Photoshop. But the process of blending the layer that you introduce, unless both images were taken same time, same lighting conditions, you know, same different color values, it can be a huge chore, but not with Harmonize. All right, so I have this photo. I don't remember where I took it, to be honest, but I took it a while ago, back in, 2010. So it's an old photo, and I edited it just for looks. And so I found this stock photo over here, and so I'm just gonna drop it in here. And so you can see right off the bat just how different everything is in terms of lighting and tone. And so with this layer selected, I'm gonna do something very easy. I'm gonna go ahead and click on Remove Background. And Photoshop's Remove Background is just, I mean, it's ridiculous how good it is. And so you can see here, we now have this person standing here. I'm gonna go ahead with the move tool and position her accordingly. And I'm also going to zoom out a bit and transform and just make her a bit smaller so that kind of perspective wise, she matches the image. So something like that. All right, let's zoom back in here. Now, as you can see here, the two images have wildly different color and tone. And so if you were to look at this, you're like, well, this is not natural because this person, you know, if she was actually standing here, should look different based on how the sun was out and the weather conditions. Well, to fix this, all I need to do is go up here to this toolbar and you see this button called Harmonize. I'm going to go ahead and click on it. And you can see, I mean, just how it does an amazing job at kind of reblending or harmonizing the layer that you introduce so that the light, the way the light falls on the person and the color all match. Now you can see here, there are multiple variations. So I can click here. That one actually looks really good. And that one's also good, but let's see, let's do this and let's turn the layer off. And so you can see just how much more natural it looks. Now, of course, you can always click on generate again to generate three additional variations. And you can just step through these as well. Like, I think that one's my favorite. Actually, no, I like this one. This one is a bit more subtle. And so again, we were able to take this image, which again, it would be very time consuming to blend this image in with the surrounding scene, but we're able to do it very, very effectively just by clicking on the Harmonize button. Now, I have another example here. So just to illustrate that it doesn't only have to work with people. So I took this photo several weeks ago in San Luis Obispo, California. And I also took this photo a few weeks prior when I was back in New York City. And so obviously this is a yellow taxi cab. And so just like before, what I want to do is I'm going to remove the background. So let's go ahead and click on that. And so we have this floating taxi cab. I'm going to go ahead and position it here. Let's go ahead and transform and make it a little bit smaller, just so it kind of looks like it fits perspective. And I'm going to angle it just a bit, kind of like that. Maybe put it here, there. All right, so now I'm going to commit the transform. And just like before, I'm going to click on Harmonize. And I mean, this is amazing. The way it blended the light and color of the taxi so that it looks like it's driving on this road in California. This is clearly a New York City taxi cab, but also the shadows. And so you can see here, we have these variations. Like this one's fantastic and this one's also good, but I think I'm gonna stick with that one. I mean, it going from this to that, I mean, it looks like the taxi cab is driving through the scene. I'll go ahead and click on generate again just to show you that we can get even more variations. That one's actually, that's close to perfect. See, that one's good. That one's, no, this one is fantastic. I mean, it looks like someone hired a New York City taxi cab to drive them cross country to California Central Coast, which is just wild. I love this. So I hope you kind of can see why I'm so excited about Harmonize. Again, it's one of those things, I admit, I don't composite photos often, but sometimes I want to have some fun and just mess around in Photoshop. Like I spend 99.5% of my time in the Lightroom. And so when I use Photoshop, unless I'm doing something specific, maybe like focus stacking or applying an ordinate effect or something like that, yeah, I do my thing and I get back to Lightroom. But every now and then, just because Photoshop has so many tools that aren't in Lightroom, it's fun and it gets the creative juices really, really flowing. Like, I loved this idea when I saw it and I was just really happy. As you can see here, the way the position and the way I executed the movement, the kind of long exposure of the taxi cab, it looks like it's driving through the frame. Now, there is one last thing before I send you off that I want to show you, and it's a preference setting in Photoshop, and it's not just for Photoshop beta. It's also good for Photoshop, the public shipping version. I highly recommend you check this out. All right, so the setting that I'm talking about can be found if you click on Photoshop and then go to Settings. You'll want to go to Image Processing. And specifically, I'm looking at this first dropdown for Select Subject and Remove Background. Now, I think the default is device. And if you click down here, you'll see there's device and cloud. And next to it, it says device is quicker results and cloud is detailed results. So I'm going to select device here, and then I'm going to click on OK. And you can see I have this layer here, device. And then all I'm going to do is click on remove background. And so you can see that Photoshop does a very, very good job of removing the background. But let's see what cloud can do. So I'm going to enable this layer. I'll hide the layer below it. And then before I do anything, I'm going to go back to settings, image processing, and I'm going to change this to cloud. Then I'm going to click on OK, and then I'm going to select remove background again. And so now if I zoom in, here is the result with removing the background using the cloud preference. And then if I show the underlying layer, do you see how there is more of that green background? So basically what I'm showing you is that the cloud version of remove background and select subject is far more precise. You can just see right there. I mean, it just does such a phenomenal job of removing the background. So I personally do recommend using the cloud option, especially if you use the select subject and the remove background options a lot. You might as well take a little bit extra time up front and just get a much better selection. And so here, really quickly, one more time, I have this background, and what I want to do is blend these two together. So just like before with this layer selected, I'm going to click on Harmonize. And you can see we have these three different options. Like, oh, perfect. I love this one. And especially when you compare the original image to this one, like this one looks like it is blended in perfectly. Just one more time, you can see that is the original. And then this is the harmonized version. And so again, AI may not be for you. You might not be interested in any of this, and that's fine. But at least hopefully you've made it this far into the video and you have a much better idea of Gen Upscale and especially Harmonize and the potential that it affords. And now you can decide whether this just has no place in your workflow, or maybe you can find some creative use cases when you're going to do some compositing. Now, this is Photoshop, obviously, but probably I would assume it's safe that you are a Lightroom user. And if you want to learn everything there is to know about Lightroom, then please do check out my course called Lightroom Everywhere. I'll leave a link to it in the description below. And I've got all of these Lightroom videos here in this playlist. Be sure to check it out. If you found this video helpful, though, please do click the thumbs up button and be sure to subscribe and click on the bell icon to get notified of all future videos. Thanks a lot, everyone.